So the Basement Boutique was born because I wanted to play a different style of music than I play out, because, you know, it's like anybody, you don't want to do your job when you get back home, or like, or listen, you know, I didn't want to listen to kind of like hard house or trance and stuff like that. So I like loads of different styles of music, like breaks and techno and electro, anything. So what I found that I was enjoying myself more when I was down here playing a different style of music than that when I played out, but you know, it's kind of like that. It's just a more grown up thing that I wanted to do. It was like, you know, I've been there 18 years now and had the accolade of, you know, number one hard house female and stuff. And even though it's amazing to have that accolade, it's very hard to shake off as well. And people don't, sometimes they want you to move out of that, but you've got to go forward in music, don't you? Otherwise, you can't be creative, you know. So yeah, I've done a lot of like techno kind of mixes, put them on SoundCloud, MixCloud, and I was kind of getting like into the top 10 of, you know, into the ratings. So decided, well, why don't I do another side of me, which is the Basement Boutique side, which is more of, more chilled, a little bit more laid, makes me be able to express what I want.
So places that you've done so far are?
Well, it starts next month, 1st of August. Right. Basement Boutique, we're doing like intimate venues. You know, intimate venues.
What's that? What's
happened? Just going.
Intimate venues through the UK. So I'm just looking at kind of like the vibe that you kind of get in my house, which is just chilled. Do what you want to do. I'll play some good music. There's no, you know, no kind of stipulation of what I'm going to do, and I can just free spirit to do what I want to do, and then also get those the DJs in that area, like the town that I'm going to play. It's a competition to be, you know, to put your mixes into SoundCloud, and I'll pick one or two techno or house DJs to come and accompany me.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Brilliant concept. So, also, you're the ambassador for Girls on Dex. Now, we kind of spoke about that before as well, but tell us a bit about that. I know you've already had the competition last year. Is there going to be another one this year?
There's definitely going to be another one at the end of this year. We started it last December, and we know a lot more about it now. It was like, it was hard to kind of do something that was just predominantly girls, even though you do get lineups with predominantly guys. Because, you know, I've done the research, I did the Brighton Music Conference, and I found out the statistics, and they're quite shocking, really, that, like, you know, 0.1% of the festivals in the UK are female DJs there. And I'm like, why is that? You know, and I just want to give them an avenue, or a, you know, kind of like a starting block where I didn't have from the beginning. So if I can find those people that will, you know, kind of the DJs that want to enter the competition, is getting them to enter it, and like, you know, and then I judge it, and there's some amazing prizes that I can do, like, at the end of the day. So, you know, and I the girl who's won it now.
I know, Miss
Kiff.
Yeah. So why, what made her stand out to the rest? Why did you pick her as a winner?
I liked her music anyway, and she was a pretty cool girl. She's South African, and Miss Kiff in South Africa is like cool. And she basically was, there were six of them shortlisted, and it was, it's a little bit loud. Six of them shortlisted, and in Manchester at the SFR studio, I basically put them in front of like a panel, where there was me and two other people. Because it's all, it is a high pressure thing, you know. You go onto a stage of like, whether it's two people, 5,000 people, you know, like, it's still a pressurised thing. And she was the one that actually the decks weren't working properly. And she went,
really?
Yeah, and she went and she just basically sorted it out. You know, she was like that, it ain't working. Somebody help me please before I start, I can't do this and that. And she knew what to do, putting music together to be a DJ. It's like putting the music in a selective way to build a set. You know, if you've got an hour set, you build that to the hour. 2 hours set, you build it to that. So I'm just kind of looking for confidence, somebody that I know that I could put on a stage, say, like,
maybe you just take on anything.
Yeah, exactly, because that's what you've got to do. I mean, the amount of times I've been in situations where, oh my god, but you just deal
side trance,
side trance when I'm playing like the big that's what I kind of play now, which is a kind of like a montage of like everything that I love about music. It's like got a bit of trance, got a bit of melody, got some really dirty bass lines, and
because I've never even heard of like kind of side trance until Joe told me about it. I was like, oh, Lisa's doing like side trance. I was like, whoa, what is this?
Yeah,
crazy.
It's just a step up from what I did. Right. Otherwise, I wouldn't do it. It's something that I actually started off with from the beginning. Okay, like, going to the DIY parties and outdoor kind of events kind of thing. But it's got a techno kind of bass line in it. When I first started playing, I always did like the hard house stuff, but then I'd do the breaks kind of and the old like big beat and stuff like that. That's what I love kind of as well, you know, hip hop and stuff. But there isn't any style that I don't, I suppose, gabba, operatic gabba.
Operatic gabba.
I think I'd be very good at that. Techno babs.
So Cole Cox, he premiered your latest like techno mix, isn't he?
I can't believe that, like, he played three in one go at Miami.
And he did it at Albert Hall in Manchester as well.
He did it at the Albert Hall in Manchester.
I was down there with someone else. I thought it was you, Joe, but I was down there with someone else and it was a proper cool gig.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
it's a brilliant space, isn't it?
Yeah.
Have you played there before?
No.
It's brilliant. So how did you and Carl like become friends? Are you guys gonna like be producing any stuff
together? I would love, you know, like just to even you know, to go over to Ibiza this year and go to you know, his night on a Tuesday or whatever is enough for me, and to him to play my tracks, it's like it's amazing. And when I went to see him in Liverpool recently, he said that I've got kind of like a progressive edge but with a thundering techno bass line. He said that no one else has got, and that's why he likes my music, because
what can they expect?
I suppose they can expect like an hour and a half of tunes that I can just basically play like that I love. I wouldn't ever go and play a track that I don't like. Whether it's called good at the time, you know, I'm not that kind of person. I'll always find the B side to a track called the double B.
Yeah,
you know,
it's
kind of like I want to look a little bit more into that. I'm not anybody that follows any kind of lead kind of thing. So I'll just give it. Marks Spencer's used to come back home because my roommate had some decks, so I used to play on it when he wasn't there. At lunchtime, for Marks Spencer's come back on the bus.
Brilliant.
And do that, and then my friend did a party. There was the guy that was going to be starting the Superclub in Birmingham and asked me to be resident. I was like, just not even ready at all, but
obviously.
I was playing with Pete Tong, you know, who else? Bon Garnier, like just everything, like Tom Ford, just Jaws, and that in my first like month. I'm thinking, wow, do you know what I mean?
Oversold, amazing.
And wasn't ready, but
issues with Viva.
Yeah.
It was being dressed by Javier.
Lovely Joe
over here.
Yeah.
So, I know you guys have known each other for a while, haven't you? What do you like about her brand?
Well, it's just like different. It's like edgy. It's like kind of, you've never going to see her anyway. She would shop and just go and buy a dress or whatever, because then some people like it, you know, like that kind of thing. But you know, Jo's stuff is like perfect. Everything I would want somebody to make, she just makes it, and without even knowing. Like today, like the outfits
were probably
90. What was it? 93 was the first 92. One. That's never come. 92. Like
really? Is that how long? What, the first one?
Yeah.
No way. And that fitted you perfectly.
I know. Incredible. And I showed Joe like a coat in my wardrobe. It's my favourite kind of thing.
Right.
And it's exactly the same, like with the just amazing. Just makes you feel like a woman, lovely waist, you know. Yeah, why not? To be honest, I don't get to go out to see them DJ, you know. I wish that I did, you know, have the time to go do that. I try and do it at festivals and stuff, but there isn't that many DJs to go be in my day. She's paying, unfortunately. But, I mean, I love Nicole Mutua. She's just the epitome of techno cool underground cool. You know, it's just like that. Just flick your hair in my face. I'd love that. But, you know, I don't know, because there's not that many out there that want to come forward, because there isn't that avenue for them to do that, is there? So, you know,
I heard there's a really good one in Manchester though, right?
Yes, really, really good one in Manchester. I think she's really good scratcher.
So, okay, right, so from... one of the biggest female DJs, if not the biggest, come on.
I bet you the biggest one.
Yeah. We're not big that way.
No.
What would it, what like top advice would you give to an up and coming DJ like me?
Well, it would be definitely find your style of music that you want.
Yeah.
Because people want you to have that kind of, you know, what we book is what we expect it. Then again, in a way, it's like, but I've got that accolade of I'm going to play that and play that. Just be good at your job, just practice. Yeah. Just like, don't let anybody like put you down and say, well, you don't want to be doing that. Don't follow any trend because then you're just going to be like, you know, in and out. So just like, just play what you want to play when you're
from the heart kind of stuff.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. And also bribery for promoters. Always
three questions and one answer again. So, favourite DJ of all time?
Cocox.
What's your drink rider at gigs?
Two sparkling water and a white wine.
Nice one. I like that. I like that. Best headphones you've ever used?
Sennheiser.
Alright, cool, cool, cool. Which genre of music do you whack on in the morning to get you going for the day?
I like a bit of Boney M and stuff like that. Like kind of like poppy kind of, yeah, I do. Just jolly kind of whatever. Awesome breaks and stuff, like, you know, DJ Icy, like dirty breaks or whatever. That's not my icon. Or Barbra Streisand, if I have to be completely
the way we were.
Take over. Yeah. Yeah.
Shiny, happy people. Right, cool. First ever Saturday job
was with my mum at a place called B-Wires where I used to work in the kitchen in the dishwasher.
B-Wires?
B-Wires. She had a restaurant inside a clothes shop in Coventry.
Oh, okay, cool.
And I worked there with my best friend Margaret, Maggie, who I still see now.
Maggie?
Maggie! She did, she used to slap us around the head. I'm like, what are you doing? And just come in and like slap me and go, just in case I miss something.
Right, this is supposed to be like short answers.
Sorry.
Your guilty pleasure tune?
Probably like Susie Carr, All Over Me, it's called. Because it brings back loads of wicked memories of where it all kind of started, really.
So, cool. Yeah. I like that. Do you know what your what the number one hit was when you were born?
I do actually.
Do you? Friend,
but I can't think what it bloody is now. I've got it upstairs on a little CD. It was something
tell us
really
later.
Old. Yeah, like, you won't know it.
Okay, so next one was going to be first thing we ever bought.
It was Stand and Deliver by Adam and the Ants.
Was that it? What? Yeah, exactly. Oh, he says Coronation Street.
Coronation Street, but I don't watch TV, but like really, I don't. How would you watch TV when it's down here? Constantly, do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Right, Wicked Babe, that was awesome. Thank you, thank you so much. Oh, you're amazing! Like, totally been inspired by you today, thank you. Seriously, yeah, that was wicked.
Thank you.